welcome to Aplos Bernama Web TV. I'm Azlina Sani, your host for today. We have with us in our studio is UTP Vice Chancellor cum ESCON 2016 Chairman Dato' IR Abdul Rahim Hashim to tell us about the upcoming World Engineering Science and Technology Congress, which will take place on 15 to 17 August at KL Convention Centre. Thank you for coming, Dato'. Okay, Dato', can you share with us the idea behind the ESCON?
Well, ESCON started off, is actually based on the mission of the university. The mission of the university normally consists of, in our case, is on three parts. Mm-hmm. One is normally the university will actually create and generate knowledge, mm-hmm. Which is done through research. The next one is actually in terms of how do we actually disseminate that knowledge, which is through teaching and learning. And the third area is in terms of how do we actually develop the students themselves. Because that's basically the three mission. Mm-hmm. So for generating knowledge in terms of through research, one of the areas that one does, of course, obviously is to go into detail in terms of the areas of research. And they will actually produce papers as a result of the research. And nowadays, also research is that you will actually do on a sort of a multidisciplinary approach. You might know there's not even one domain that you have to consider. You have to consider other domains as well. Yeah. And the best way to actually showcase your research is having conferences, so that other researchers from all over the world will also come. Yeah, to share their knowledge as well in the same areas. For example, in our case, ESCON, we have 9 conferences in Nepal in one congress, so that they can interact with one another. So the basic objective of ESCON is really to showcase our research outcomes through papers. Why do we do it by having 9 conferences in one go? Is that so that they can interact with one another? Because some of the research, for example, which are UTP, we have 9 mission-oriented research areas. For example, 5 of it is oil and gas; the other 4 too is related to society and community and issues at large. So some of the areas, for example, which are nanotechnology, you can actually be applied into the enhanced oil recovery or even carbon dioxide management areas as well. So there is that interaction. And also, this is also a platform for the industry to come on board. So the industry understand what actually we are doing as far as the university is concerned. And also the general public. The general public doesn't know in terms of what research that we are doing. So the ESCON will provide them also with a platform for them to come and then see what exactly the university is doing. So if that's of interest to them, they can pursue the subject matter with this. So that's I guess the overall picture as far as ESCON is done.
This year, ESCON carries engineering, science, technology and humanities convergence for a sustainable future. What was the theme chosen at all?
The team is actually the previous team is the same. Again, the reason for that is that nowadays when you actually do research, it covers also areas which concern societies and communities. So you cannot completely isolate yourself from just researching your own domain without knowing the implications of other areas, especially relating to, I guess, human behavior, society's behavior, community's behavior. So you have to take that into account when you do actually research. Because a lot of research that is done is for the benefit of society and communities. So, and if that's the case, then the question is that, what impact, first of all, does it have on societies and communities? And how do we actually then address some of those issues that comes up? And sometimes the research that we do is actually an issue that relates to society and communities at large. Mm-hmm. problem that they have, then we bring it on board and say how do we actually solve all this. We go a bit more detail in terms of the sciences and engineering too. How do you solve that? But again, it impacts societies and communities at large. Yeah. So humanities ni covers all aspects. No?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it covers the interaction of poor people, the interaction of communities and sebagainya. So we see there must be an interaction between the science, engineering and humanities at large. So the question is how do they actually converge? That's the challenge that we face. Yeah.
Okay, we want to know how ESCON help in the development of various of fields, especially in science, technology and humanities.
Okay, in terms of course, basic research, you know, is to get, you know, I say, generate new knowledge. Yeah, new knowledge. Now, if you just generate knowledge as you, and then people do not subscribe to what you have researched, then no matter what's the purpose of your research. So the outcome of some of the ESCON, for example, we produce, of course, papers is very important because this is your field of research. The next important thing is how important is the research. Now the importance of research is in terms of through what we call citation. That means somebody else from somebody who's actually doing related research will actually refer to your paper. They will actually refer to the paper in their paper. So and so, your paper is being referred. So your paper is being cited in that sense. So in our case, kalau nak tahu in terms of the impact of research, the citation is very important. Kata macam 2010, we first started our ESCON. Now, in terms of citation, we monitor the citation. Now there are about 2,400 citation. Yeah, because it takes time for your paper to be cited. Kalau you buat paper hari ini, I mean, most likely it will not be cited until next year or subsequent years. Yeah? Yeah? So we monitor in terms of citation. The other one we monitor is in terms of patents granted. Yeah, does your research, is there going to be patents or not? Yeah, which is going to be filed, for example. Kalau macam 2010 itu, we have got 20 patents that we have filed. Yeah, the other area that we monitor which has impact is that daripada papers, daripada research that you do, when you apply for grants, which is actually money from from the government, are you successful or not? Because there are criteria to say whether research you need relevant or not, and then if you are is relevant, then if you should be successful, then we monitor how much money did you get actually from the grants that from the proposal you send to the granting body itu lah. So we monitor, and then we monitor also berapa MOU that you have, how many of this research areas that you present is being commercialized and sebagainya. So banyak lah, a lot of areas that we look at, so that it is not just for the sake of doing conferences only without any implication or consequence. There is actually an implication and consequence to that.
Okay, Dato. ESCON 2016 different from the previous ESCON. Can you tell us?
Well, of course, every ESCON, we're trying to do an improvement or new things that we want to put on board so that it is an innovation. So for this year, we have the so-called innovation pitching session. Yeah? Why that is important to us is that it's also to showcase some of our research outcome, which has the potential to be commercialized. Yeah. So this year, for example, we have 40 outcome of research, which we think has got potential for commercialization. Yeah. And this pitching session will be aimed towards people who wants to invest further into those particular areas. For example, we have got the Platform Ventures. Now, Platform Ventures is part of Agency Innovation Malaysia, AIM, AIM. And we have also from MDEC, for example, who will come and be and watch the researchers pitch their project and says why they think that their project has got commercial value. That's one. So that's being done. The other one that we have is that to attract industry players is to have forums and seminars within those conferences themselves. Because sometimes when you have conferences like this, you have papers presented by academician, it can actually be quite dry. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, you are talking among themselves and so forth. So we said, now how can industry contribute to this? So we bring the industry on board and do a seminar where people will speak for about 10 to 15 minutes. Yeah, there's three or four of them. There's a moderator, and then they will have a dialogue with the participants and be a bit more lively in that sense. So we have that coming on board. So that's some of the, I guess, innovation that we bring on board as far as this Congress is concerned.
Right. Okay, UTP will be also organizing carbon offset project called Save the Earth. Can you share with us what is the project is all about?
Now, in any conferences that one does, obviously, there's a lot of resources that one spends. Yeah, for example, there's a lot of papers that that you use. Yeah, there's a lot of, I guess, other resources that you utilize when you do a conference. So we said, now how can we actually offset that's something that we took from nature and we should be giving back to nature. So one of the ideas that was mooted when we started in 2010 was to plant trees. Yeah, I mean, if we plant trees, then the trees will take the carbon dioxide in and then release oxygen out and stuff like that. So and also at the university we have actually 1,000 acres, yeah, of which half is a forest, 500 acres is a forest, the other 500 acres is extinct mining land. So extinct mining land is that if you don't do anything at all, nothing will grow. So the question for us is that one of our CSR area is actually environment. So how do we rehabilitate the land so that it gets back to, try to get it back to its original condition, with trees and so on and so forth. So one of the areas that we say is to have to plant trees. Mm-hmm. Now, so far from 2010 until now, we have planted about 600 trees altogether. And the way we do it is that the staff will actually sponsor these trees. Mm-hmm. Yeah, for example, this year we said each tree will cost 300 ringgit for anybody who wants to sponsor. And some of the proceeds from that 300 ringgit, of course, to buy the tree and to help plant it. But anything extra from there will go back to Yayasan UTP. Now, Yayasan UTP is a foundation which provides assistance, financial assistance to students who can't afford or who needs financial help. Who needs financial help, we will actually go through Yayasan UTP to help them. So, in a sense, the growing of the planting of the trees has got a lot more outcomes to it. Yeah, not just to offset what we have utilized as far as resources concerned, but raise a bit of money, a bit of fund to assist students who are financially, I guess, in distress or not being able to cope financially, so we assist that. And the trees that we plant, originally it was meant to be normal trees, but starting from 2014, we're now planting fruit trees. Yeah, just to give it a bit more flavor. Yeah, so hopefully this year, the previous year we have some mangosteen, some guava trees, some other fruit trees, but this year we're going into durian trees and other trees as well. So it gives a bit more flavor to the campus. Eh? So that's the idea behind all this.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, Dato, what is Dato's expectation for ESCON this year?
Now, expectation, obviously, with the economic situation being especially for the oil and gas sector, where the oil prices has dropped from 100 last year down to 30, now it's back to $50 a barrel. Obviously, it impacts the industry overall. The question is that whether can we get the same number of participants as we did last year or last 2 years. So the challenge for us is that if we can manage to get the same numbers as 2016, we are actually very successful.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's one in terms of getting delegates to come on board and then do the presentation, and also getting foreign participants to present papers and also participate. So that's considered will be a success to us. But I think more important is to make sure that the innovation that we put on board, this innovation pitching session, will hopefully in the future result in products being or services being commercialized, and perhaps better citation, and then more patents to be filed, and obviously the participants who actually participate in the conference itself will see a value add. Yeah, I think that's our expectation. Mm-hmm. So we just not get numbers, but I think in terms of getting people to be able to network, and maybe some of the outcome that we'll get is better collaboration, better networking. Hopefully organizations will collaborate better, result in at least MOU, at least, and then from there on, their relationship will take them further in terms of better outcomes.
Okay, Datuk. Lastly, how can the organization, industry, and member of the public can be part of ESCON 2016?
Well, we do it in terms of broadcasting it in various means. We issue emails specific to individuals.
Mm-hmm.
We go through trade associations, such as MOCSI, Malaysian Gas Association, other trade associations as well, to get as much reach as possible. They can also go to our website, www.utp.edu.my/ESCON2016. So they can also do that and get some of the details in terms of what the details of the program itself, the 3-day program. And I think if they are able to come, one of the advantages is that you have 9 conferences in one go. Yeah, it's actually the world's largest congress of such a nature. And for the fees that they pay, they can go to any of the conferences, without having to pay for additional fees as such. And we think for public at large, the fees is actually very reasonable. Yeah, one person is for 3 days is 1,500. Yeah, but if you come for 1 day, it's about 1,000. Yeah, per day. Then if you are a group of 5, it'll cost you ringgit. So it's I think it's something that's affordable for I guess people who comes about who wants to attend the congress itself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you, Datuk. We hope ESCON 2016 will be a resounding success. All right.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
dan juga MX Mall. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah hari ini satu lagi orang kata peristiwa yang sangat bersejarah bagi Simplicity kerana kami bekerjasama bersama dengan MX Mall, satu portal yang memberi peluang kepada peniaga-peniaga untuk menjual secara online, malah melalui Facebook juga mereka boleh terus membeli produk Simplicity. Dan ini antara portal yang memberikan servis yang paling rendah pada mereka yang ingin menjual produk mereka di portal MX Mall. Jadi saya sangat menggalakkan ramailah usahawan-usahawan wanita di luar sana yang menjual produk online. Jom sama-sama kita ke MX Mall kerana memberi servis yang sangat sangat rendah dan terbaik, insyaAllah. Hubungan ini terjadi sebenarnya saya memberi kepercayaan ini kepada anak saya itu, anak pada Datuk Sri Khalid juga, Muhammad Ashraf, untuk mengembangkan lagi jualan produk Simplicity kerana saya melihat bahawa Simplicity sebenarnya satu produk yang bagus, kualitinya terjamin dan ramai yang memuji dari segi setelah menggunakan produk Simplicity. Tetapi sayangnya kita tak dapat reach banyak pelanggan. Jadi dengan adanya MX Mall ni, dia membuatkan pelanggan Simplicity mudah untuk mendapatkan produk. Mereka hanya perlu purchase online dan kami akan terus menghantar kepada mereka yang membeli. Saya melihat kerjasama ini satu kerjasama yang baik dan boleh membantu produk tempatan untuk pergi lebih jauh lagi, insyaAllah. Saya of course saya happy dan saya gembira. Saya nak wawarkan lebih ramai lagi. Jom kita berniaga di MX Mall. Dan saya melihat bahawa MX Mall banyak memberi perkhidmatan yang benar-benar membantu pelanggan kerana charge yang dikenakan hanya RM20 saja. Yeah. Jadi kita tahu tumpuannya adalah untuk meramaikan lagi peniaga dan memberi perkhidmatan yang terbaik pada mereka di luar sana. So doakan semoga kerjasama ini berjalan dengan baik. Yeah. Kalau siapa-siapa nak produk Simplicity lepas ni, bolehlah melayari MX Mall dan anda boleh memesan terus daripada sana.
Tidak mahal, cuma RM20 sebulan untuk mempunyai online store di portal kami. Jadi saya amatlah mengalu-alukan peniaga-peniaga di luar sana untuk berniaga di MX Mall. Jadi dengan sokongan Simplicity dan juga influencer-influencer yang lain yang anda semua boleh lihat sendiri di portal kami, kita bersama-sama mengembangkan perniagaan e-dagang.
Thank you, Mas
Warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Saya Muhammad Ashraf bin Khalid, Eksekutif Director in Simplicity. Hari ini kita punya event adalah untuk mewawarkan tentang kerjasama kita dengan MX Mall. Maxmo adalah satu online platform yang disediakan untuk orang-orang macam kita lah, untuk buka store dengan mudah supaya kita punya produk is easily accessible by our consumer. Yeah. So hari ni kita buat pelajaran antara MXMall dan CB City. Selain itu, kita juga nak membawakan tentang billboard yang MXMall telah hadiahkan kepada CB City. Kita ada dua billboard dekat Malaysia, di Jalan Duta dan juga di Jalan Jelantik. So hari ni pun kita nak bawakanlah tentang adanya billboard tersebut, kan. Okay. Tujuan utama kita join MXMall adalah untuk menjadi leader lah di antara brand-brand tempatan yang lain untuk join MXMall. Kita, we want to be one of the first brand yang join MXMall, and kita nak dapatkan lebih lagi usahawan-usahawan muda untuk join dengan MXMall, sebab kita tahu yang dalam Malaysia ni bidang keusahawanan tengah ramai orang tengah berminat, and ini adalah peluang yang terbaik lah, sebab e-commerce adalah salah satu platform atau industri yang sedang berkembang dengan pesat. So it's definitely a place for brand like CB City to be part of lah. Don't forget to get CB City product dekat mxmall.com/simplicity. Di situ kita ada semua selection produk kita, and you boleh dapatkan produk kita di mana-mana, tengah tidur ke, sebelum tidur ke, tengah nak makan ke apa. Bila-bila masa kita boleh dapatkan produk CB City di MXMall.